Hi, my name is Megan Pinchback, and I'm the owner of Dyslexia On Demand, the premier provider of web-based one-on-one dyslexia therapy. As the owner of Dyslexia On Demand, I frequently speak to parents who have recently received a dyslexia diagnosis and are feeling overwhelmed with what that means and what to do next. I'm here today to provide you with a very simplified explanation of what is dyslexia and what happens during a course of dyslexia therapy. When an individual is dyslexic, it means that their phonological processor is not working or it's underfunctioning. For a regularly functioning reading brain, your phonological processor is the part of your brain that has the ability, with automaticity, to recognize the letter K, understand that the letter makes the K sound, and those letters and sounds can be built and manipulated to produce new words and sounds. Someone without dyslexia likely assumes that when they look at a large word and can recognize it instantly, they assume that their brain has it memorized, but it literally is your phonological processor that decodes each letter in nanoseconds behind the scenes in order to provide meaning to the rest of your brain. It's also the part of the brain that, without explicit instruction, starts to independently recognize phonetic patterns, syllabication, and the placement of word accent. In the brain of a dyslexic person, this isn't happening. They tend to rely on their ability to memorize words and can often see words as pictures and shapes. This is why often the simplest words in the English language are read in error because they're seen as the same shape. Think of in, is, or his, him. Additionally, people with dyslexia generally also have an impaired working memory and impaired rapid retrieval skills. So, while decoding, as their brain tries to labor over attaching meaning to each letter, they've forgotten what they've already made their way through. For this reason is why when you read a word cat on one line and then you find them decoding it again on the next line. A dyslexic brain requires a different form of instruction than what is classically offered at school. Since the 1920s, we've known that the dyslexic brain requires a multi-sensory approach in order for their brain to have more to grab into. If this part of your brain is not working, we need to light up all the other areas of the brain simultaneously in order for the brain to grasp the information. This is much more complicated than it sounds, so that's why it's important that you understand the difference between dyslexia tutoring and dyslexia therapy. The term Orton-Gillingham is a very familiar term for many after a few Google searches on dyslexia. Recognize that Orton-Gillingham is not a specific program for dyslexia, but instead an umbrella term for a dyslexia intervention methodology with a multisensory approach. Not all evidence-based Orton-Gillingham programs are created equally, so visualize it as a building versus an umbrella. Programs that fall in the lower floors are often those you can access in the schools. They require little to no training to implement and have no time requirements. Additionally, the facilitator generally has little knowledge of dyslexia. They know how to read the next lesson in the teacher's manual, but they don't understand how to troubleshoot or customize to your child. Dyslexia therapy, on the other hand, is the gold standard level of intervention. There are only two therapeutic level programs that exist, and you must be a certified academic language therapist in order to deliver them. Dyslexia therapy is not a common offering outside of Texas or Arkansas, but luckily anyone can access this programming through virtual one-on-one therapy at Dyslexia On Demand. Dyslexia therapy is explicit, systematic, multisensory, and high repetition instruction for both reading and spelling. Through an extremely specific presentation style connecting the auditory, visual, and kinesthetic in a specific sequence, cults literally are creating new neural pathways in the dyslexic brain so that they can access the written code. A course of therapy is delivered at an extremely high frequency rate, meeting 4 times a week for an hour over the course of 2 years. It takes this amount of time in order to rebuild the brain's pathways for every phoneme and grapheme of the English language, including the explicit rules for syllabication, accent, and even word morphology. Cults and dyslexia therapy do not cure dyslexia. Someone with dyslexia will always be dyslexic. Left untreated, reading and writing for someone with dyslexia feels like someone unfamiliar to a stick shift trying to drive a manual transmission in a thin, windy road in the mountains of Germany where all the signs are in German. Imagine the amount of focus and frustration it takes to be successful. After completion of dyslexia therapy, the brain now has the right tools to make it just feel like the amount of focus it would take to drive on that windy road, but the rest feels automatic and natural. I hope that this has helped provide a brief and high-level understanding of dyslexia and the difference between the more commonly found dyslexia tutoring and dyslexia therapy. Regardless of the number of cults in your particular area, thankfully there are virtual therapy options such as Dyslexia On Demand, offering that caliber of intervention to students regardless of their geographic limitations.